The Master is one of the most cerebral films from the consistently great Paul Thomas Anderson. Despite what some have said, the film's main focus isn't Scientology or religion, although it does delve into the types who tend to be drawn to that world. It's more of a fascinating window into the psyches and relationships of two very deeply troubled individuals. Freddie Quell is a veteran who finds himself deeply entangled in a religious cult, led by Lancaster Dodd, a man who seems to appoint himself the absolute master of all his followers, and yet his control over new disciple Quell grows weaker over time. The relationship is a push and pull one, where Dodd eventually tries to come to grips with his inability to control Freddie. That final scene between them is Lancaster pretty much begging Quell to bend to his will and accept him as his absolute master.
If you leave here, I don't ever want to see you. Or you can stay.
Freddy, on the other hand, just wants the man that he admires and helped him so much to stop lying to him and give him a reason to stay. Lancaster's words neither renews Freddy's faith in the cause nor gives him any hope of change in their dynamic. They both care a lot about each other and want to be close with one another, but their bond is ruined because each of them just wants something different from their relationship and their fundamental natures clashing. Freddy wants to be an equal, but Dodd wants to be his superior. Because of this, the relationship fractures. It's as if the man behind the curtain in The Wizard of Oz had a close friend that wanted to stand beside him, and he rejected that friend. Because having someone standing next to him would be a constant reminder that his false persona is in fact false. Dodd is in fact a fraud, however he'll never admit it to anyone, but perhaps his own master, which seems to be his wife. What is interesting about the film is that its core seems to lie in psychology, more specifically the psychoanalytic theory of the three egos, id, ego, and superego. Each one of the film's three central characters seem to represent one of those three egos. Freddie obviously represents the id, which is the instinctual component of personality that is present at birth and is the source of bodily needs and wants, emotional impulses and desires, especially aggression and the libido. Peggy Dodd represents ego and acts according to the reality principle, which operates the ego and is a regulating mechanism that enables individuals to delay gratifying immediate needs so that in the long term they bring about benefits rather than grief. Lancaster represents the superego, which reflects the internalization of cultural rules, mainly taught by parents applying their guidance and influence. The main goal of the superego is to suppress any urges of the id that are considered wrong or socially unacceptable.
A good night to you.
Freddy, stop! This is not the time, stop!
The film uses these molds not only to delve into the very nature of the three egos, but also to show how those egos conflict with one another, and uses that to guide the characters to the natural conclusions of their relationships. Freddy ends up drifting, barely satisfying his base needs. Lancaster remains in his leadership role in the cult, and Peggy remains by his side because she sees a utility in it. Paul Thomas Anderson's film is not only a masterclass in filmmaking, but also one in how to craft authentic and complex characters that interact in an honest way. Do you agree with my explanation of The Master? Comment down below if you do or don't.